everybody. So today we're going to be making a strawberry banana smoothie. And I have got fresh strawberries and I put them in the freezer. So they're frozen now. It's best to start out with frozen berries instead of, just regular room temperature berries, because it'll give your smoothie more of a cold, slushy consistency. And then one banana and your milk of your choice. I'm using unsweetened vanilla almond milk. Okay, so now we need to get our blender and plug it in. Okay, so let me go ahead and do that. And I'm using one of these Ninja blenders. You can use whatever kind of blender you have at home. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna peel our banana and put it in there. And I break it up into little pieces. It just makes it easier on the blender. Okay, and then we're gonna measure out 1 cup of milk. So I got my liquid measuring here. Oh, gotta open this. And I'm gonna pour in 1 cup. Okay. Now we're gonna do 1 cup of berries. So I'm gonna have my measuring cup here. This is half a cup, so I'm gonna do this twice. And you just want to fill the cup up with your berries and put it in. And you can take the green part off of the strawberries if you want. It doesn't really bother me, so I leave them on. Okay, got my strawberries in there, and my banana and my milk. Okay, that's it. And twisting the lid on really tight. And I'm gonna go ahead and put it on the blender. And we're gonna blend. It's been blended enough. That should be when you don't hear the strawberries going around anymore, about 30 seconds. You can take it off the blender and pour it in a cup and see how it tastes. Now, here's the thing about when you make anything is always try it first and you might decide you want to add more of something. Mmm, tastes pretty good. There's still some things in here that didn't get blended all the way, so I'm going to put it back on the blender, and I'm actually going to add another banana because I have a lot of bananas right now in my house, and I think I'm going to add another banana so that I can get rid of these, and it'll also make it sweeter. So the bananas help the smoothies taste sweet in addition to the berries. I'm gonna put another banana in there. This is totally optional. And back on the blender it goes. Okay, that was another 30 seconds on the blender. And we'll see how this tastes now. Okay. Mmm. So adding that second banana helped thicken up the smoothie and it tastes a little sweeter. And I really liked it with the two bananas. So you can choose to do it with one banana or you can double your recipe. You can even add more strawberries if you'd like. And if you wanted to make this for two people, you would double everything. So that would be 2 cups of milk, 2 to 4 bananas, and 2 cups of strawberries, if you want to make one for a friend. And the nice thing about smoothies is you can always add different things to it. So if you didn't have strawberries and you had blueberries, you could do the same thing and just do blueberries instead with the banana. One thing I recommend is every time you make a smoothie to always add bananas. The bananas are what makes the smoothie be flavorful. Next time you can even add chocolate to it and you can have a chocolate strawberry banana smoothie. Some people like to add greens to their smoothies, so you can make a green smoothie. You can have the same recipe as what we just did, and then you can add a handful of spinach to it. And when you do something like that, you don't really taste the spinach, you just taste the berries and the banana. And it's a great way to get your greens in for the day, and lots of fiber. So thanks for staying tuned, and I hope you enjoyed the smoothie. Let me know how it tastes.